Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It's not enough. Not for me. For the glory of God.
Hallelujah.
Let us be active in the kingdom of God. Not lukewarm.
Hallelujah.
Let's pray. Lord, we thank you for this blessed opportunity that you have given us and me to minister the word today to dear saints. Lord, use me as your mouthpiece. Whatever to be said, to be uttered through my mouth by the help of the Holy Spirit. We surrender everyone. Lord, in the grace of your words, give you the glory, honor, and praise, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Hallelujah.
We are all aware of the present situations which is going on, and probably we are suffering it more nearly 2 years, what is happening. And you know all, the corona, the virus, the end time signs, the wars, rumors of war, it's all happening. What does it show? What does church, what does it show as the word of God? It shows the coming of our Savior is here.
Hallelujah.
But are you ready? Are you, when I say you, 3 fingers are here. Eh? When one pointing to you, 3 fingers are pointing to me. So are we ready for his coming? Long time back, I think I have given a small message with some illustrations about the rapture. How many of you remember that? Tabitha came and told me afterwards, "Appacha, you scared us." I said, "It is going to happen." Many people think it is a fairy tale. It's a fairy tale. As the disciples who were walking to their Emmaus, they said, "We thought it's a fairy tale." No, it's really going to happen. So be ready for that. Okay. See, these things, as I said, you know, this is the signs of the rapture, which is going to happen. You know, recently, when this corona started, India government had put a mission. What is it? Vande Bharat mission. What was it? What was it? India was trying to evacuate his citizens from this country because of the pandemic situation. And you know, when there is a crisis happening between two countries, you know what will happen? First, the country will recall their ambassadors. Correct? Am I right? The same way. Who are we? Ambassadors of Christ. God, we are the citizens of heaven. So God will not allow us to go through this tribulation. That's what I believe. Amen. We are the ambassadors. We are the citizens of heaven. So are you happy? But you should be ready for that. Simply you won't go. I tell you, it's not an easy thing. Christ will never allow his bride to go through all these things. That's what I believe. Some people believe in post-rapture, pre-rapture, and what is that? One more rapture, mid-rapture. Whatever it is, rapture is there. Thank God it is there. So if somebody wants to suffer and go, let them. But most churches believe this is a pre-rapture. I don't want to put it as an argument or anything. You believe according to the way you want. Oh, okay, you all know the Thessalonians, what they say. For the Lord himself descends from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. The first stage is, who is dead in Christ will rise up. Okay, and second stage means it's in split seconds. Then we who are alive and remain, who are here, will be caught up together with them in the, so they will come, we will go together to Jesus in the midair to meet Jesus. That is the scenario which is happening. And in Corinthians 15, Apostle Paul talks, it happens within a twinkle of eyes. You know it? So it happens. So it's going to happen. It is a reality. Please think about that. Okay, as the scripture reveals, the time, as the scripture reveals, there is a criteria for to be a part of a rapture. You don't think that you will simply go. Oh yes, I am born again, I will go. No. Please, don't be such an impression. There is a systematic way of life which Word of God is telling. Not me. You have to follow that. Okay, let's see what Jesus said. First is faith, correct? In John 1 we say, but as many as received him, to him he gave the right to become children of God, to those who believe in his name. So faith in Jesus. One more verses. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whoever believes in him. More than anything else, the famous prayer of Jesus on John 17:20. He himself is praying, I do not pray for these alone, but also for those who believe in me, believe in Jesus through their words. So believing in Jesus is the first criteria. Okay? And second, you know, recently only I understood the meaning of the verse. Romans 3, if you can put here somewhere, Romans 3, 23, it will be fine. Romans 3, 23. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God, being justified freely by his grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. The next word is 25th word. Whom God set forth. 25th word. Yeah. Whom God set forth. See, if you read in English, I don't know how far you can understand it. When we read in Malayalam and even in Tamil also, I will read it in Malayalam itself. വിശ്വസിക്കുന്നവർക്ക് അവൻ തൻ്റെ രക്തം മൂലം പ്രായച്ചിത്തമാകുവാൻ ദൈവം അവനെ പരസ്യമായി നിർത്തിയിരിക്കുന്നു. യു നോ ഇറ്റ്സ് എ പ്രസന്റ് ടെൻസ്. ദി ആക്ട് ഈസ് ഡൺ 2000 ഇയേഴ്സ് ബിഫോർ, ബട്ട് ജീസസ് ഈസ് കെപ്റ്റ് ദർ, ഓക്കെ, ഫോർ എനി വൺ ടു ഗോ ടു ഹിം ആൻഡ് ടു റിസീവ് ഹിം ദ ഫർഗീവ്നെസ്. ഹല്ലേലൂയ. It is from the old age, those who sinned yesterday or those who is going to him tomorrow, or today, tomorrow, or until the last day, until his coming, that he is there. He's kept. So when I read that Malayalam, you know, it gave more depth to that. So many times I thought, oh, it's 2000 years before happened, you know how it is. But it is there. He's publicly kept. Parasyamayana theeriyunnu. He is kept there. Whoever wants to get forgiveness, you can go and get your forgiveness. That is the word. Okay, the first criteria was faith. Now second is born again. Second is you have to be born again. So let me say, the title of my message is, Are We Truly Born Again? Are we truly born again? In John 3, you can see what Jesus is talking to Nicodemus. And even in John 13, who were born not of blood, nor the will of the flesh, nor the will of man, but of God. Do you see any provision to become born again by your own? By this work? Not of blood, by hereditary, not the will of flesh, I myself, or not the will of man. So none of us can be born again by ourselves. Only by God. I don't know. Don't take it as a controversy, please. Eh? See, by taking a decision, I'm born again. No. Can Shiny be born again to a Sheikh family? You decide, I'm going to born again, born in a Sheikh family. No. It's God. So born again, it has to happen by the Holy Spirit. By simply accepting Jesus, lifting hands, you will not become born again. I'm not telling don't do that. But the true born again, the real born again, a rebirth has to happen. Okay, when Jesus is talking to Nicodemus, okay, you know the story, I'm just going forward. Nicodemus said to him on John 3:4, how can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter second time into his mother's womb and be born again? Jesus answered, mostly, surely I say to you, unless one is born of water and the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. Again, Jesus himself is telling that which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. Do not marvel that I said to you, you must be born again. The wind blows where it wishes, and you hear the sound of it, but cannot tell where it comes from, where it goes. So is everyone who is born of the Spirit. Nicodemus answered and said to him, how can this be? Then Jesus is asking, Jesus answered to him, are you the teacher of Israel and do not know these things? Okay, here in verse 5, Jesus says, those who are born again is like wind. What is the speciality of the wind? Nobody knows from where it comes and where it goes. It goes according to the direction of the one who sent. Who has sent the wind? God. God is sending the wind. So a born again person is moved or behaved according to the direction of God's will. Like a feather in the wind. How is a feather? You are a born again guy. The wind. Wind is the born again experience, the direction of God. Okay? And how the feather, when it is flowing, it goes like that. When it is flowing, it goes like that. When it is flowing, it goes like that. Like a feather in the wind. You hear the word of God always. Hear God's direction every now and then of your life and go accordingly. That is the born again experience. There is no set pattern in the way of Holy Spirit. It works its own pattern. Hope you remember that once I told that God didn't want Adam to know about the good and evil. I don't know how many of you remember. Thanks for the memory anyway. God doesn't want Adam to know. That's why he said not to eat the fruit of the tree which gives you the knowledge of good and evil. Why? Is it a bad thing to know good and evil? When we look? No. Right? God didn't want. Why? Because he wanted Adam to move according to his will, always hearing from him. He was like that. But when he disobeyed, the scenario is changed. You know, the decision of the good and evil, it's not in the spirit realm. It is in the soul realm. You get it? It's in the soul realm. That's why God didn't want. He wanted the man to move in the spirit realm, to hear from him and move accordingly. Okay, now coming. While Jesus is asking to Nicodemus a question, Jesus answered and said to him, "Are you the teacher of Israel and do not know these things?" How come Nicodemus, who is an Old Testament teacher, know about born again word? How come? There's no word. That is, yes, as it is directly not written in the Old Testament. Correct? Hi, Danny. Why you're staring? Is it written there somewhere? About, no. Not directly. But there is. If there is not such a word which means this, definitely Jesus would have asked him so. I want everybody to read that. I'm going to put Ezekiel 36, 25. Just, you have to go through this. Can anybody read for me? Okay. Can anybody read?
Jesus answered and said to him, "Are you the teacher of Israel and do not know these things?"
Sorry, okay. I gave you a new house. Okay. 25. Then I will. Ezekiel 36:25. Then I will sprinkle clean water on you, and you shall be clean. I will cleanse you from all your filthiness and from all your idols. Okay, then verse 26 and 27 and 28. I will put my spirit within you and cause you to walk in my statutes, and you will keep my judgments and do them. And verse 28, then you shall dwell in the land I gave to your fathers. You shall be my people, and I will be your God. And 29, I will deliver you from all your uncleanness. I will call for the grain and multiply it and bring to famine upon you. Okay. Here, the prophet Ezekiel is giving a promise about the new covenant. He's talking about a new heart. Instead of stone heart, I will put fleshy heart. And he is going to put the spirit upon you. You know, many people, when they say about born again, they say the water is word. Correct. To a certain extent, water is word itself. Because when we heard the word, then only we get some idea and we get born again. But here, the baptism. About the water, they talk about baptism. So it's not baptism. Baptism is an act which is done by us. Correct? We do that. But here, what God says, did you take it out? Okay. What God says, I will sprinkle clean water and I will put new spirit. It's completely from God. You know, the rebirth, the regeneration will happen like that by the help of the Holy Spirit. So I believe Nicodemus is convinced by the word. Do you think so? I think so. Why? Because you can see him in John 7 advocating for Jesus. John 7:50. Nicodemus, he who came to Jesus by night, okay, being one of them, said to them, "Does our Lord judge a man before it hears him and knows what he is doing?" He's advocating for Jesus. In John 19, and Nicodemus, who first came to Jesus by night, both the places they are mentioning who came in the night. It means definitely he would have satisfied with the answer which God gave, which Jesus gave. And he is convinced and he became a disciple. And what he did, he came bringing a mixture of myrrh and aloes, about 100 pounds. He came that spices to wrap Jesus. So Personally, I believe he became a disciple. Do you agree with me? Hallelujah. That is words of conviction from God. I'll give you one more word from New Testament. Titus 3. For we ourselves were also once foolish, disobedient, deceived, serving various lusts and pleasures, living in malice and envy, hateful and hating one another. But when the kindness and love of God, our Savior, toward man appeared, not by works of righteousness, which we have done, but according to his mercy, he saved us through the washing of regeneration and renewing of the Holy Spirit. This is done by God. Washing of regeneration and renewing the Holy Spirit, whom he poured out on us abundantly through Jesus Christ, our Savior. So this regeneration happens by the Holy Spirit. So truly born again, now I'm coming to the main point, truly born again people will have a repentance. No, they are dead. As the word says, the old is, all this gone, dead. It's a new creation. How will you know whether you are dead? How they checked Jesus? They wanted to check whether he is dead or not. So if you get an arrow, an accusation, if something that somebody is talking against you, you are not dead. Hello? You are not dead. If you are talking tit for tat, if you have something, not even talking, if something coming in your mind, because he sees, you are not dead. Are you afraid? We are all not dead, including me. It should reflect in your life. When you talked, or husband and wife, when you leave, how is your family? How is your, how do you, husband, do you love your wife? Wife, are you submissive? Are you talking TikTok talk? Are you getting angry? No, if you are born again, it will not happen. It will not happen. They will leave as per the word of God. Hallelujah. The change should happen in our life. I think I'm going somewhere. I went out of my point. Okay, so we have to die. Die. It is no more I, it is Jesus. We always say, you know, we have the mind of Christ. Very proudly, oh, we have the mind of Christ. What mind do you have? Do you have the mind of Christ? Do you have the forgiveness like him? Do you have the patience like him? Do you love your enemy? Do you pray for your enemy? What is your attitude? And don't simply claim I have the mind of Christ. Don't simply claim. I'm talking about me too, please, always. Holy Spirit wanted to talk this, maybe to me also. What is your attitude? Time. Yeah, let's finish it. Okay, one more criteria. Not only that, holiness. 1 Thessalonians 4 says, for God did not call us to uncleanness, but in holiness. We should have to follow. No one can see in God without holiness. Holiness means, it's not, oh, I am holy, I will not talk to anyone. No, sannyasi, no, no. It's not that holiness. You are in this world, but you are not of the world. That's what Jesus said. Love everyone. If you are thinking, you are not holy. If I am thinking you are not holy, it means I am a self-righteous man. God will not allow. God will not entertain me at all. Oh, those people, they all watch movies, this and that. Don't. I am safe. I am saint. No. then you are a self-righteous man. Don't judge anyone. Love everyone. Always, you know, I am a love preacher. That is my main subject. Because God is love. God came to this world not only to die for our sins, but he came to give his life and nature to us. That also we have to understand. Okay, we are all self-centered. Self-centered. Our measuring rod is I. That's why I get angry with you. I measure something with my attitude and then I get angry with you. I measure something with my attitude and then I get jealous with you. Correct? When you are self-centered, you will have all these vices. That's why I said, die. Die. I'm no more. I'm no more. Then that agape love of Jesus will flow on you. Hallelujah. I'm just finishing. I'm giving a checklist for all of you, including me. Checklist. Go home and just check. Are you getting anger? Are you jealousy? Do you have pride? A spiritual pride even? A selfish mentality? Do you ever say that, oh, they did to me like that, so I will do only like that? Mentality. I will behave as they behave to me, that's all. It's not what God wanted. An extra mile. An extra mile. Are you ready for that? That agape love should flow from us. Otherwise, no point. I say, we'll not go. We'll be left out here. Pure and holy. Don't think that I'm born again and I can go. Lead a life which is pleasing to him, a holy life. Daily crucify flesh. Left out in the rapture is not a small thing. You have to go through so much pain. Please understand. Try to be a part in the rapture. I don't know. Read Revelation, then you will understand what is the tribulations. Nobody will be able to go through it. You can be a martyr and maybe you can go, but before that you will deny him. Such a pain will happen. So please think whether we are truly born again. Don't simply say, I am born again. Whether these qualities are in you, in us. Forgive others, love others, go an extra mile, okay? Pray for enemies, pray for them, bless for them. I don't know, whatever Jesus said, he set an example to us. Hallelujah. I'm just closing. Lord, we thank you for this opportunity, and Lord, whatever you have given to my heart, I have just poured it out. Lord, I pray, Lord, let this word die and bear fruits in the hearts of the people. Let them be blessed. Give you glory and honor in Jesus' name. Amen.
It's not enough. Give more. Hallelujah. Please stand on your feet. He asked Papa Zachary, asked everyone, are you really born again? Number one. Second thing he didn't ask, I am asking. Second one, If you really born again, are you keeping the true experience of born again until you die or Jesus Christ comes? Because Bible very clearly says, Matthew 24:13 and 1 Corinthians 5:23, if today Jesus Christ come or we die, where our real born again experience? So people of God, born again, it is not one day business. Until we die, until Jesus Christ comes, anyone first comes, we have to keep our born again experience purely, purely, purely. That means it's not our pure. The God's expecting something. According to the God's desire, we have to keep our holiness, our experience. This is the God expecting. Then we no need to worry about anytime Jesus may come, we will go to along with him. Close your eyes. Heavenly Father, thank you for the word you spoke to your servant, Father. Once again, Father God, you remembered us. The signs, everywhere the prophecy is fulfilled. Indirectly, the word, Father, today, speaking to us, Jesus is going to come very soon. Let every church, the body of Christ, to prepare. The same thing, Father God. Once again, Father, be remembered today through the message. Father, we don't want to put that word lightly. We want to take more serious. And we have to go home and think about, are really we ready? Father God, I applaud the Zachariah and your grandfather. Coming days, Father, use him mightily for that thousands, Father. I bless him as a man of God, along with the brother Bobby. We bless him, Father God. Give him long life and healthy life, Father. I uphold, Father, his wife John's sister. Bless, same way, Father God, the entire family. Father God, in the moment, I bless each and every one, Father. Until we're going to meet next week, let everyone carry the blessing of God. I surrender the rest of the things in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. 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 The people of God, raise your right hand and receive the benediction. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit, and the mighty protection be with us now and forever. Amen. 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 Children of God says, God bless you. Amen.